There are three design topologies available to deploy F5 in our infrastructure. They are one-armed deployment, two-armed deployment, and NPATH or direct server response deployment. Let's discuss about this one by one in detail along with the sample network diagram. Okay, and as the name says, one-armed deployment, here in this type of deployment, our virtual server and the actual application server, which is also called as the pool members, will be in the same VLAN. So that's the reason it's called as one-armed deployment. And there is a small drawback in this method. However, there is a methods to overcome this drawback. Let's see in detail with this diagram. Let's understand how this one-arm deployment works and how to overcome the drawbacks. In this topology, we have a user from 192.168.10.0/24 network. So the user IP is 192.168.10.7, and we have another network 10.10.10/0/24 where your virtual server and actual application server, the pool members, are hosted. Okay, and generally in this type of deployment methods, the default IP, the default gateway IP configured in the server will be the IP address of the router. Okay, and let's see, when a user traffic hits or when a user traffic comes into the network, how it behaves. Okay, say for example, if a user, we have our test www.testfi.com, a sample of a virtual server configured in the FI. Okay, if user want to access that web application www.testfi.com, once the DNS reservation is completed, it will give the IP address like 10.10.10.50, which is the virtual IP address, right? So once the user gets the IP address of virtual server, the request from user will come through the network and goes through the router, and it reaches the FI, right? So once it hits the virtual server configured in the FI, and as we know earlier, as we know already, that by default FI will do destination NAT, right? FI will do destination NAT and not the source NAT by default. Okay, and if we need, we need to enable source NAT, but by default, as FI is in a full proxy setup, it will do destination NAT. So when I say destination NAT, here the user from 192.168.10.7, he may not be he don't have any idea about the actual server where your application is hosted. Okay, as per the user, the application server is 10.10.10.50, which is the virtual server which is configured in the FI. Okay, so once the request hits the virtual server, FI will replace the destination IP address from 10.10.10.50 to any of the server's IP address based on the load balancing algorithm configured. Okay, so this is what known as the destination NAT here. And as I said already, FI will do destination NAT by default and not the source NAT by default. If we need to perform source NAT, we need to enable it. Okay, so once the packet, once the request reaches FI and hits the virtual server, it will perform the destination NAT, and based on the load balancing algorithm configured here, the packet will be forwarded to any of the server. Okay, let my request is forwarded to the server number 2. Okay, and before forwarding it, what it will do, it will replace the destination IP address from 10.10.10.50 to the destination address 10.10.52. okay, and if you see, all the IP addresses on the same subnet. Okay, so, and once the request hits here, as we said earlier, the default IP configurations, the default gateway configurations in the server is the IP address of the router. Okay, so once the server reaches receives the request from the user, when responds to that packet, it will not actually forward it to the FI because the default gateway configured here is the router. So it will respond directly to the user through the router, because as we said earlier, FI will not do the source NAT by default, it will perform only the destination NAT. So when the server receives the request, in this request packet, the source IP 192.168.10.7 is available. So when replying to that particular request, instead of sending it to F5, it directly forwarded the request, or it directly responds to the user through the default gateway, nothing but your router. Okay, so here it's an asymmetric routing that happens because your actual request comes from the user through the router. It goes to F5 and reaches the server. However, your response bypassed the F5 and it goes directly to the server in this way. So this is the asymmetric routing that that will be happening in this deployment method. However, we can mitigate it, or we can overcome this by implementing SNAT, which is nothing, a source NAT. Okay, so once we enable source NAT, when the request from the user hits F5 and when it performing the destination NAT, it will perform source NAT also, which means that it will replace, or it will change this source IP address also, and so that we can avoid this asymmetric routing. Let's see how it will work if we change that source NAT, or if we configure the source NAT. 1 minute. So when by default once we configure SourceNet, right, when the user request comes in this way, okay, and hits the F5, here in this request the source would be 192.168.10.7, nothing but user's machine IP address, right, and the destination IP address would be 10.10.10.50. okay, and once the packet hits the virtual server and the FI, it will do both. Once we configure the source NAT, it will do once the source NAT, and by default it will do destination NAT also. Okay, based on the round, based on the load balancing algorithm, the packet will be moved to any of the servers. Say for example, as per the load balancing algorithm, if the packet is moved to this server, forwarded to the server, in this packet the source would be replaced as 10.10.10.50, which is your IP address of the virtual server. And it depends on the source net method we are using. There are some types, there are different types of methods we can use: source net auto map, source net pool list, like that. So based on that method, it will take the, it will change the source IP address. So it will now it will take, it takes the source IP address as the virtual server's IP address, and the destination IP address is the actual application server's IP, which is the pool member's IP address. Okay, so this is how the FI will perform source NAT and destination NAT, and it will forward the packet to the server. And during the return packet, so now the server received the request, right? So when it responds it, it will check for the source IP, and the source IP what it mentioned is already 10.10.10.50, which is the virtual IP's address, right? So it will forward the packet here instead of moving the packet directly to the user through the default gateway. It will forward the packet to F5 because the source IP address is 10.10.10.50. Okay, and once, and here in this packet the source would be application server IP 10.10.10.53, and destination is 10.10.10.50. okay, 10.50 is nothing but the virtual server's IP. So once the packet reaches the F5, here again it will perform the destination NAT and source NAT, and it will be reaching the user. And here now the source will become 10.10.10.50, and destination will be 192.168.10.7, which is the IP address of the user. Okay, so by enabling the SNAT, or by configuring SNAT, we can avoid asymmetric routing. So it's not that if it's an asymmetric routing, it's a mistake or it's an any issue. But the main thing is, if it goes by asymmetric routing, if it bypasses the F5 during the replay and it works as like an asymmetric routing, then it may miss the future of using F5. Okay, so that's the reason we can mitigate it, and we can overcome the drawback by using source NAT in the one-armed deployment. And the other way is, the second method is, it's an two-arm deployment. As the name says, both the virtual server and the application servers, the pool members, will be in the two different VLANs. So if you see in the example, our web application testfi.com has the virtual server IP addresses 10.10.10.50, and if you see the application servers, the pool members, they are in the 172.16.10.0/network. Okay, and these servers will be having the default gateway as FI's self IP. Okay, here FI self IP is 172.16.10.1. So in this deployment topology, these servers will be having a default gateway as FI's self IP. Okay, so whenever user want to access testfi.com, post to the DNS reservation, the packet will comes to here to the FI, and here when the packet comes, the source is 192.168.10.7 and destination is 10.10.10.50. okay, and as we said earlier, as we discussed earlier, FI will perform destination NAT by default, and if we are not enabling or if we are not configuring SNAT, it will not perform. And for this method, we no need SNAT for this setup, okay, for this topology. So once the request hits FI, here that it will perform destination NAT, and based on the load balancing algorithm, the packet will be forwarded to the server. So let it be this server, let it move to this server. So when the packet comes here, the source will be still 192.168.10.7. There will not be any changes in the source IP address. It's still the IP address of the user, okay, because we have not configured any SNAT, source NAT. By default, it will perform only the destination NAT. So the destination IP address is changed as 172.16.10.11. okay, so once the server response to the request, it has the default gateway to the IP 172.16.10.1, which is nothing, the self IP address of this FI. Okay, so, and request is comes from this FI now, and the default gateway is again pointing towards FI, it will respond to FI as with source as 172.16.10.11 and destination is 192.168.10.7. okay, so once this packet again received in FI, FI will again perform the NAT, and it will change the source as 10.10.10.50, destination 192.168.10. When I say it will perform only destination NAT by default, it is for the request. Okay, in this case, when the packet returns from the server to the user, here it is performing source NAT. Okay, so that it replaces the actual server IP address with the IP address of the virtual server. Okay, and the packet will be mode. So by this method, as this default destination method, the end user may not have a direct visibility about the IP address of the actual application server or where the applications are hosted. Okay, so this is two-arm deployment, and the third one is nPath deployment. This setup or this topology is similar or the same as like what we have used in one-armed deployment. But here in this method or in this topology, as per the design itself, we want the server to directly respond back to the client instead of going through the FI. So whenever a request comes, as per the design, this is the requirement actually. Whenever a client request hits the FI, here it will perform the destination NAT, and the packet will be forwarded to the available server based on the load balancing algorithm configured. And once it reaches the server, here in the server, the default gateway would be the IP address of router. Okay, and as the source address is 192.168.10.7. So now the server will reply to that request directly instead by bypassing FI. It will directly respond to the user. Okay, so this is the nPath deployment. So these are the three possible design topologies used for deploying the FI in our infrastructure.